What up, the people behind the camera over there on the other side? Nice to talk to you all on here. And yes, I have High Water on the brain. A very fun dance show. Oh my gosh, that's all I gotta say. You probably don't know, but I like dance. I'll never call myself a professional. I am taking a class just for, you know, because I can and all that. So yesterday I was out at Target, because that's usually a place I choose to go to. Target, if you know, usually most of the stuff I get is at Ulta, but Target at times too, because Target has like a more range of stuff, so I might look around for other things. But I got polish there. I got these, both Sally Hansen polishes, as you can tell. This is their extreme, very cheap polish. This is their more expensive, but this one's really good in these bottles, like I've told you in my last video. And all that. I guess it's like a one-step thing. I don't really get what that means. I kind of get it in the clear polish, but still, I don't 100% get what this means, this one-step thing. The Emer. What the? Oh, I gotta show you this. Oh, darn it, really? It's blurry? Well, that's fine. And then I have this other one that's Tinkled Pink. Tickled Pink. Oh my god, this is... I'm putting some... My fingers are going to be all tickly. Oh my gosh. Yeah, this is $1.99. And this is $1.78. This is like something from Sally Hansen. You know, like they have this whole thing of gel. They have one that's the other kind. And then I guess I have this one that's like the one steps. I don't 100% know what that means. If you do, maybe you can put it down below, because I've never really looked it up. I just have polishes that say that. Usually it's the clear polish that says it that I get from them. But yeah, I'm going to be combining these two, at least trying them. This one is going to be the base for all my nails, and then I'm going to try this on top. So I might do this on all my nails, but let's get to it and get into the nail making here with these very pinky girly nails, because that's what I feel like. I'm a girl. Doesn't mean I don't do some harsh dark nails like you've seen, but I do like my I am very heavily to a nice pink, to a nice ooh, because I see it on people's nails and it looks ass. If you do it right and everything, well, you can make it look good. But yeah, let's get into it right here, right now. So here's a blank canvas ready to paint on this pink of pinks. Oh yes, this is one of my all-time favorite colors to kind of use when I really want to go girly. So here we go, putting it on, and as you can see, it's going to need another coat and all that. This is not like wow woo woo polish, because so it's going to be a little finicky as you can see. But there we go with that, and now showing you my typical finger. I usually always show with my middle finger here. No, I'm not because of that, just because it's like, just because, you know. But yeah, so there's that. Putting it on nicely there and all. Getting it nice and put together and everything. Right there, here, and of all that. Just getting out some of the creases so there's not these bulged up areas of nail polish, because you don't really want that. You gotta do that soon because you know how it works. So there's that and all. Now I'm gonna put on the sparkle, this thin kind of goldy sparkle. It kind of has like this very rose gold, you know, like those cell phones. Oh, that's pretty cool. Pretty cool. And on that, here's getting all nice and ready to put it just on the tip, because I tried it with it all and I liked it more just on the tip. So there we go with that. Well, to that, those awesome nails. And yes, I had to change it up. And if you noticed, I don't know what was up, but I had some video weirdness that when I actually was doing the tip of the nail, like you see on these, the tip is just the sparkle. It didn't show very well, or I was off camera somehow. So I had to delete those, so you just saw the aftermath of it. But on that note, it has been about a week, and this is the result of my nails, how they've lasted and all that, and that's pretty good, right? And this is on this hand. Of course, usually this one is the one to go out a little bit more, because it's my right hand, used more and all that. So as you can see on that finger, it's chipped. I had not chipped that. It was just got like that itself and all that. And this one's a little cracked up here. But it looks really still really good. But I didn't put a clear polish underneath. because it's a really, really light color. And sometimes with a light color, you don't have to, because it won't tint your nails usually very, very much. I remember nail care education said that if you use a light color, you don't really need to put clear polish underneath and stuff like that. This stayed on really nicely. I do want to maybe get some more of that one polish I use that's clear at some point. But when it's a nice light color, it won't really tint your nails very much at all. But I don't recommend doing it all the time. You want to make sure, because I have put blue on my nail. Like, oh, one fell off. I need to fix it, because sometimes that happens. And it's usually these fingers. And I want to fix it so I don't have to have one nail without it, and I don't want to redo it yet. And then I was like, oh, shit, I shouldn't have done that. You know what I mean? Because you think, oh, I just put it on, and I'm not even going to take the time to put the clear polish. But then you're like, the clear polish is a nice cap so your nails don't get hued colored. It still might happen slightly, but it doesn't really happen. If you want your nail polish to last, I recommend a good base coat, and always use the same base coat, because pretty much I use the same one. I've just been using the other one from Sally Hansen, and I think it's not really good enough for being a bottom coat. It works somewhat, but sometimes it falls off too easily, but that's that. I always experiment. Sometimes it's good, sometimes it's bad. Sometimes I'm like, okay, this is what I got, I'm gonna use it. It might not be made for a bottom coat, base coat, but I use it anyway. So on that note, this is how they lasted with these two Sally Hansens. The cheaper one is the bottom, and then this one, this awesome like kind of brand on the top, and that. And this is a very simple manicure, so simple. It can take about 5 minutes or so. You just gotta wait through the things to dry. This one I did a little longer because I was like, I did it, and I was like, oh, I want it. So it's kind of like a coat, and then I kind of went, oh, sparkle, and I didn't like it, so I went, a coat, and then I put the sparkle on the tip. So I kind of did about 3 coats of the color. Usually you'd only, if it's more like the Sally Hansen gel ones they have, you got this color and that, you would probably only need about 2 coats. 2 coats is good because it makes it last longer, and it shows the color better. I know someone's like, oh, 1 coat would be awesome. But I always do 2, even if the color is amazing at 1 coat. Because it makes it last a little longer and all that stuff. So, and maybe if there's any little places where you slightly didn't put any, sometimes the top coat can just make it all smoothed out. But on that note, I will leave it to there. I hope you enjoyed these very girly nails ready for the springtime. Even if maybe it's spring for you, but it's cold, cold spring. Like a friend of mine, it actually literally snowed in spring. So on that, I hope you enjoyed all this with these nails and many more to come, because I'm really enjoying this. But if there's anything at all that you think that you might enjoy a little bit more for me to do, because I'm always wanting to know what you guys want, because I'm here to do nails because I love doing nails and all that. But I can always do something that makes it more interesting for you guys. Maybe just curious. So on that note, with that pink to the sparkly sparkle, till next time, sparkle, sparkle, bye!